Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats for the story of glory.
For a little bit of football come. everybody, and welcome to our 2019 Carol Service, The Story of Glory. It's really good to see you all. My name's Gary, and this is Lorraine. We are the core officers here, which means we're the ministers. Make of that whatever you like. It's good to see you all.
It is. Although I can't actually see you all properly, I did get to say hello to most of you on your way in. I would like to welcome you all here. You're all VIPs, very important people, and it's really lovely that you're here. In particular, I would just like to highlight some people that have made a special trip. So we have with us today Mrs. Gillian Beasley. She's the chief executive of our council. We have the leader of the council, John Holditch, with us, and his beautiful wife, Barbara Holditch. We also have the mayor with us today, and that is Gul Nuaz. We have the mayoress as well, that is Areem Corsa. And we have Bella Saltmarsh, chief alderman Bella Saltmarsh, with her other half, Jim. And it's lovely, lovely to see you. Also, Gary and I's boss is here, that is Major Martin Hill, our divisional leader. He looks after all the Salvation Armies in quite an area, including Peterborough. So we will behave the best we can this evening.
No chance. So you should have all received a welcome leaflet when you came in, which will help you know what's going on and what to expect, but it will also help you to take away with you this evening the big picture of what we're trying to say and what we're trying to help you remember this Christmas time. We hope you've arrived healthy and expectant and full of excitement this evening.
Yeah.
And your expectations this evening could be singing some Christmas carols, maybe. It is a carol service, after all. Hearing the Christmas Nativity story and what it means to us and can mean for you today. Some laughter. Some time to reflect. And some good music, which we've already heard this evening. You can expect those things, I think. And it comes free of charge and with love. And the prayers of all of us that we've prepared for this, for each of you this evening.
We've titled this evening, The Story of Glory. And on the back of your welcome sheet, there's a little Bible timeline, if you like, a short brief one that you can take home. And its crowning story of glory is when Jesus is born and the people really, truly discover God's glory properly. So in the tiny baby in the manger, through the life of Jesus and after his sacrifice and resurrection, we know Jesus' glory shines through his dedicated followers every day. So our prayer for this evening is that we all hear this crowning moment of God's glory when he came to earth, and that we can find where we may fit in and where we can, and some of us do fit in. So we pray this for you all.
So I think a good way to get started with that is singing a Christmas carol, don't you?
Yes.
I think anything else would be inappropriate. So we're going to sing one of my favourites, O Come All Ye Faithful. The band are going to help us. We'll sing three verses, and I think we'll stand, shall we? We'll sing the three verses, and we'll follow the band master, Paul Andrew, to bring us in.
Thank you.
Because there's just too much to fit in. We'd be here all night just doing that on its own. but I'm going to share with you some of the recent things of the community work that we've done. And through the work of our members, our people, through volunteers, and a lot of them, and through the work that we do here in this church and also in our shop in the city, we do an awful lot. So here's a snippet of that. Salvation Army is a church that gives. We put our faith into action, and that's why we aim to do as much community work, making a difference to people's lives, physically, socially, mentally, physically, as we can, and of course spiritually as well. In the new year, we look forward to getting together as a group of people and deciding what this church's aims are for the next year. And so we'll be doing that. If you'd like, we're going to do an offering because we never did charge this evening. If you can, and if you're able, then you can give in a collection that will take place in the next carol, which is Joy to the World.
Resources. We thank you, Lord, that you've blessed us with enough to share. And I pray, Lord, for this generosity that's been shown this evening, that we here at the Salvation Army can really bless this community in your name. We pray, Amen.
I'm going to read to you from Luke chapter 1, some verses. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. you have found favour with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end. How will this be? Mary asked the angel, since I am a virgin. The angel answered, the Holy Spirit will fall upon you. The power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One will be born and will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail. I am the Lord's servant, Mary answered. May your word to me be filled and fulfilled. Then the angel left her.
So often in our news bulletins, we have statistics quoted to us of how many teenage pregnancies there have been. The world is broken, and this is good evidence of it, we're told. Children whose lives have been arrested by an ill-judged moment. The world is broken, but we'd be mistaken to think these statistics are the only evidence of its brokenness. Now, more than ever, we need to hear good news, see light, experience joy, be surrounded by glory even.
Mary, a teenager herself, when the angel came to see her, also had her life arrested by this moment. But this wasn't an ill-judged moment. This moment had always been the plan. The favour that she had found herself in was an eternal favour. But it wasn't only Mary's life who was to be turned upside down by this baby. The whole world would know his name.
Gabriel recited his news of the baby's greatness. Gabriel, the announcer, used his words to paint a picture of a world-changing saviour, echoing the words of the prophets of old. Eternal favour being announced to a teenager, but her concern was not an eternal one at all. Her concern was more immediate. Social stigma, accusatory looks, words of scorn, isolated from those that love or loved her.
Now we can all connect with Mary's concerns of the here and now. Yet like Mary, we all rest under the wings of the eternal, unimaginable love of the Most High. We aren't all teenagers, and we certainly don't know this particular plight for ourselves. But we've all had our own moments when the fear of what will be thought of us flood us with dread. And so Gabriel reassures Mary that the power of the Most High will overshadow her.
At this time of gifts and joy, may we all be prepared to share the real here and now with the eternal. Like Mary, will you dare to believe that the breath of heaven that brings light into the corners of your world you'd rather hide from? Treasure the things Gabriel says of this child in your heart. Your concerns for the here and now are real, but the here and now is not eternity. Now is not forever. Yet in some strange way, and this is the really good news of this story, this is the light, the joy, the glory, because of this baby, eternity can start here, now, for you.
the angel told Mary she was highly favoured and how she was chosen to give birth to the Son of God. Mary believed and responded to God. I am the Lord's servant, Mary answered. May your words to me be fulfilled.
singing company, and for Grace for being our kneeling Mary. You'll be hearing more from the singing company later on, you'll be pleased to know. But just now we're going to hear more from you. You feeling in fine voice?
Yeah.
Yeah, there was a definite yes from somewhere in the mist over there. Maybe we'll have a solo. Depends who it is, as you. So we're going to sing Angels from the Realms of Glory. The Angel of the North on there. It's just a nod to my wife. So we'll stand to sing. I think there's some verses to this. Three verses. There we are. I told you there were some. So we'll stand to sing, and we'll sing a three verses straight through, following Andrew as we go. Microsoft Word, so you can call them what you like, but we're going to enjoy timbrels performing for us to the march Celebrate the Season, accompanied by our own band. So if you're on the front row there, you might want to duck now and again. All right, if you don't get it first time, you'll get it the second time. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Must have been a pretty standout guy. even a righteous, standout guy is not immune from real human emotion. Joseph, whose life was all lined up, he was embarrassed, angry, disgusted, and disappointed in his young bride-to-be. We know the other side of the story. We know from this end of history that Mary was far from disgusting. We know that she found favour with the Most High. Joseph was righteous, but Mary was highly favoured. God knew Joseph's righteousness too. In fact, God didn't really care whether Joseph's peers or the writers of the New Testament thought Joseph was righteous. It is the Most High who bestows righteousness. Gabriel, the announcer, was called upon again to calm Joseph, to soothe his embarrassment and to inspire him with truth and the joy that was within his young and now isolated bride.
In scriptures it said, "You will give him the name Jesus. They will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us."
Hard as it was to accept, frightening as it was to imagine, Joseph needed the perspective of angels to show him that this painful road was well worth travelling along. Doing what's good and what's right is often a far bigger and more costly affair than walking away and giving up. The desire to do what is right and honour God won Joseph's heart and his head, and after the angel visited him in his sleep, he decided to do the right thing. In his darkness, he resolved to claim his title of righteous from the only one who can truly give it. And because his righteousness came from the giver of light, he knew he would never feel the dark ache he was feeling again. So when the angel visited Joseph in his sleep, he believed and responded to God.
Thank you.
Mary, Joseph and Morgan, and Philip, and Roy. So thank you so much for presenting that. So, we've heard from our singing company, Singing Breath of Heaven. We've also got a young people's band sitting over there. In darkness at the moment, they will be illuminated in any minute now. And they're going to play two pieces for us. One is called The Carol of the Bells, which seems to have become quite popular of late. Carol of the Bells, featuring a bell. And then following that, we're going to hear from some of our learners. And they're going to play a Jingle Bell Jive. And this is a pretty big gig for them, to be fair. So we're really excited. And conducting the YP band this evening is our assistant YP band leader, Mia Drury. And I think this is your first Christmas in that role, isn't it? So great. So we look forward to that. So let's welcome them. Let's give them some encouragement. Thank you. you know, when we was deciding what was going to be on the programme this evening, we thought, well, do you think they'll be able to handle a big crowd?
Yeah.
Pretty good, weren't they? And I thought, if they do, it'll bring the house down. Absolutely wonderful. Well done, the four of you. Well done, YB Band. Well done, Mia. Really pleased that you took part. So we've heard from the singing company already. This is our junior choir. And singing Breath of Heaven in, as part of that reflection. They're going to sing just now Melodies of Christmas. It is a medley, isn't it? There's kind of a few different ones in there, yeah. And this is brought to us by the One Voice Children's Choir, which is an American children's Christian choir. And we're going to listen. This is going to be great. I've heard this in rehearsal. It's amazing. So let's welcome the singing company.
Joy and laughter in the air, smiling faces everywhere.
going to read to you now the Bible reading taken from Luke chapter 2. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth be peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem to see this thing that happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off, and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what they had been told about the child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
My nightmare sleep. Sheep who love to go AWOL, they're asleep. Now I can read my Bethlehem Metro.
Cheek of that wolf entered my field and to fight him barehanded. Then he brings his mates out to fight them, a whole pack off. Watch out, keep your eyes peeled. That's what I say, stay vigilant.
This article's about old King David. I know that from his picture. Apparently, if I'm getting this right, he was a shepherd boy at all.
I'll tell you what, Alan, he was a right weirdo. Totally away with the fairies. You'll never guess what he did.
Yeah. He killed Goliath. With a stone. I think we all know that.
No. Even weirder than that, as a shepherd boy, he would play his harp and lyre to his sheep.
How can someone so fluky goatee like that defeat Goliath, never mind protect his sheep?
No.
One.
One.
Oh no, not again. 66 in the top field. 33 at home. One here. No, that's not right. Hey mate, I need your abacus.
Oh.
Can you give us out? Shift up.
I don't know how to use it.
Come on, shift. Oh,
not my friend.
There, take off.
Oh dear. Oh! Your code's on here for you too.
Oh, poor sheep. So, look, let me just check. So, 66 and 33. Yeah, that's 99.
99? You had 100 yesterday.
Oh, I know. It's been hard at home. There's not a lot of food. The kids are so thin, you can hardly see them. The wife? No energy. Can't even manage the housework. I had to do something. I had an idea last night, though, and I tried it.
Oh, yeah? What did you do?
Well, you'll like this. I think it might even catch on.
Shepherd's pie.
Shepherd's pie?
Shepherd's pie?
Yeah. Yes.
Ooh. You're not making a pie of us.
Don't care how hungry your kids are.
Or how thin your wife is.
Boys, boys. Relax. It's okay. I'm not making a pie out of Shepherd. I wouldn't pull the wool over your eyes. I would try and fleece you. No one's flocking to eat shepherds. No, I'm not eating making a pie out of shepherds.
Phew.
No, I'm making out of sheep.
What?
What?
It's even worse.
Out of sheep?
I don't know.
We're shepherds. We're supposed to protect them, not eat them.
We're supposed to
feed them
and look after them.
I know. But the kids loved it. The wife's got her energy back. And I felt so good. I even chased away 6 bears last night.
Ooh.
They have no idea we're here. I've got no clue.
What are they doing?
Talking about something called shepherd's pie.
You can't make a pie out of shepherds. Anyway, don't be bothered about pie in a minute.
Are you sure God wants us to be the one to tell them the awesome news?
That is what he said. I'm not quite sure what I've got to tell them. How should we do it?
Well, I think we should sing. We sing everything.
Yes.
So let's warm up, shall we? Shall we warm up?
Help us. sit comfortably as the band prepare to play. Nativity Swing.
Who exists in every
very heart of the Father has made him plain as day.
The angel's visit to Mary and Joseph turned their world upside down and yet turned all of creation the right way around. Every baby that has ever entered this world made an impact, yet this baby, declared by the heavenly host, sent ripples through all creation. Glory to God, they said. Mary had a centre stage as the glory of God was revealed to her and through her. His kingdom will never end, said Gabriel. Great, and the Son of the Most High. The teenager treasured all that happened in her heart as she, more than any other young mother, was changed by the favour poured over her. Joseph's faith and willingness to swallow his pride was essential to the scene we know so well. As he stood by Mary, he became a role model for men in his age and ours. Quiet, gentle strength that was focused on his calling to be a father. With all this wonder and heavenly involvement, you'd have thought somewhere more majestic than a shed and a feeding trough would have been chosen. Yet, in this dark and damp place, this place no one else wanted to be, this was the place that the light of the world illuminated in a new and special way. The darkest of corners, so dark that the brightness of the Christ child was accentuated. And if we're surprised by the place of birth, telling the shepherds before anyone else would have appalled some. These outcast, uneducated, clumsy men heard and saw the glory of the Lord, and they couldn't wait to see more. The wise men followed, completing our scene that encompasses the full stretch of human experience. The wisest to the lowest met and bowed before the glory of God. They all saw it and they all responded to it. Because they'd seen Jesus, they had been seen the full embodiment of the glory that had never been seen in this way before. Jesus, glory came down in a baby, and a spark of light which had already brightened some people's dark corners. Mary's faithfulness in God had been just as the angel had said. Joseph relieved and believed wholeheartedly the shepherd's words. The story of glory which began in Genesis culminated and peaked at this nativity. Let's sing Away in the Manger, and as we do that, small keyring lights will be given out to you. So let's sing together, remain seated as we sing Away in the Manger. glory of God is now seen in his believers. Jesus said in Matthew, "You are the light of the world." The angels were the messengers of hope, and God sent them to convince, to speak on his behalf into people's lives, their decisions, and their futures.
Our city, Peterborough, and every person in it needs hope restored in them. The need to not hope in the quick fix, in the paper thin, or the quick burning hope, the alcohol kind of hope, the fame kind of hope, the materialistic kind of hope, the good looks hope, the stuff that feels good for a day, but turns sour fast.
Like the people of first century Bethlehem, we need this hope. We need to hope in God, to experience this glory which is all around, yet somehow our eyes are blind. We, like them, have a Saviour of the world who loves us. We need to turn around and see him, just like they did.
We're a bit like Mary and like Joseph. We need his light to shine in us and through us. This glory that shone into the dark place is still shining today. The glory that shone into and through those shepherds is still available to do the same for us today. And here the really good news, when the glory of God shines into your life, it also shines through you and into someone else's. Shine, so the world sees a better place, a better life, a God who loves and who is not removed. Shine, so others take steps in God's direction. Shine, for the hope of eternal life, for all people everywhere.
The light of the world is here for you. His light is here for everyone, ready for you to switch on. We invite you to be shining lights in this dark world. Be the signpost. Be the messenger of hope. As we sing our next carol, the lights will go down and you can turn your little LED light on. Let it represent the light of the world. Thank Jesus as we sing for his glory. Shine your light in the darkness of this room and light it up, committing to shine so others see his glory. With you, just as the songsters are taking their seats, I just want to say thank you, Lord Jesus, for your glory, for your light in this world. I thank you, Lord, for every person who seeks to shine your light into dark places. And I pray for my friends here tonight. I pray for everyone in this room, particularly those people at this time of year are struggling with their own dark corners. I pray, God, your light will shine into their lives tonight. May they sing that they too have seen the glory of the Lord, and that they see you shining all around them. We give you the glory.
Amen. We have come to the end. If any of you feel like you wanted to talk to someone or someone to pray with you, then don't leave this place with that feeling and not do anything about it. There's a few of us that will wait down here at the bottom, and they'll be more than happy to pray with you or just be a listening ear for whatever reason you have. All right, so we'll just congregate around there. When everybody else walks out for a cuppa, you can just hang out down here and see what happens. The final collection, the collection total, I have here with me in big, in case I couldn't see it in the dark, it's £720 for today. Thank you very much indeed for giving, and it will indeed be purely used for our community work, reaching out to people. So thank you. There's an opportunity for you to have a photograph taken after this as well. You can come just congregate sort of roughly here, and Morgan can take your photograph in the space of the wings to show how angelic you are, and so you can post it saying that you were at the Salvation Army's carol service and look what happened. No, you can just have your picture taken. They will be posted on our cause Facebook page, so if you're not happy with being on Facebook, that's how you get your picture. So don't have your picture taken if you're not happy with that, but that's how you'll be able to print it out at home and share it with others. And I have said that you can have a cup of tea, a coffee and a chin wag And of course you can have a prayer if you want one, or a listen in the end. We're invited to hang around if you like. Like, you know, I meant mingle. What? They're all saying mince pie. Like, of course there's mince pies. I think the band are going to play for us a piece called Christmas Joy, just as we're preparing to leave and get on with the mince pies.